Hey everyone, this is James. We're here with another Lucid tutorial. We're going to show you how to set up and arrange fixtures in the fixture window that's in the desktop tab right here. You can see by default the program puts all my fixtures in a line, starting from the first address to the last one. So what I can do is just simply select my bars, move all four of them at once, drag it. Select my torrents, move all those at once, drag it, let it go. I can also maybe even kind of group these together, move them over. Or just kind of do them one by one. So I can just kind of lay these out however you want. You can have it reflect how you have them set up in your re-rolled application. So that's one way that you can do it. What's a good idea to do now is start making different fixture groups, and you can do that by simply selecting some fixtures and clicking on the group button right here. See, I've already made some groups. So what we can do is let's get rid of these. We just select our fixtures. Right click, as you see now. Select these fixtures here. Right click, as you see now. If you want to group these together, and these together. And if you want both of them together, you can see there's different groups. You can right click and assign a keyboard shortcut. So if I want to hit lowercase t, if I go back here, you can see this little t right there. If I hit t, it's going to go to that group. Different group, hit T again, goes back to that group. Holding control and then right clicking brings up the menu to delete the shortcut. You can also rename it for right side. Get a different, different pretty little color, green. That's why you can categorize. Groups by color. Put mine back to default. So that's fixture grouping. And what's really neat is after you created so many groups, say you created first six, close this, and G1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So G1 is linked to group 1, G2, group 2, 3, 3, so on and so forth. So that's how you can do fixture groups in here. Just kind of get creative with it. Keep in mind you also have different desktops that you can use too. So if you don't want all of your fixtures in one window, you can just send them to the next one, no big deal. I'm going to touch briefly on sequence queue and queue list. Queue list is the main portion of your playback. It contains a queue, and a queue is a sequence that either has either one or many scenes or static looks. So a queue list can contain one or several queues, and each individual queue can have one or multiple scenes inside it. So what you can do is create multiple queue lists, then create different sequences with different static scenes in them, etc. Just a quick example that I'm showing. Then you go to the live tab. Now I got my queue list. These are automatically going to play. You can can loop these, you can have these playback in any order that you want. And so, since I programmed 3 different cue lists, I can then stack different sequences between different cue lists. And if I right click, I can even set stacking mode, which allows me to trigger multiple sequences within the same cue list. So like you can see, this cue list right here is not set to stacking, it's set to released. We can set it to stacking mode, and now we can stack as much as we want. So if you put stacking mode on all of them, you could literally trigger everything at once. So, and just kind of quickly clear everything, clear live. That's what is that button right there. This will quickly black everything out. This will play all these in sequential order. Forwards and backwards. So, master dimmer and speed adjust. The reason that's flashing is because it's still active. So if I right click it, puts all my dimmer levels back to where they should be. So again, key list, key sequence, key list. You can create, say, a key list for each different fixture type in your setup. For example, if you're a DJ, you've got your uplights around the room, then you've got your dance floor lights, then you've got maybe some effects lights or some lasers or some strobes. You could create a cue list for your uplights that has many sequences that you can play back. And those sequences can contain either one static set of values or dynamic, with multiple instances of static values that can play back either with a fade or a hold time. So that's a quick look at cue list, cue, and sequence. For now, we will go into this in a greater depth in the next video. So we hope you enjoyed this one. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments, or shoot us an email to support@blizzardlighting.com. Thanks for watching.